So welcome to the Laravel permission tutorial, and in the last episode we have seen how we can set up this package and use to create the roles and the permissions and obviously the relation between them. But in the last episode we have done one thing more, which is we have used this has role trait on our user model. This means the roles and the permissions we have created now can be assigned to the user. So let's see how we can do all these things. Because of this has role trait, we can do these things. So again, let's see. I have PAS for starting the servers. Again, alias I have created. So it's now started. So we'll go to localhost and 8000. So let's now register a new user because I have flushed out the database, and now I have this. So here, if I go to my VS Code, you can see here on the index function where I have home controller. If I return hello and check this on Chrome, yeah, I have the hello. This means this is the correct file. So let's create a role. We have not created role. So in the last episode I have created, but I have, as I told you, flushed out the database. So I need to create one more. So create, and giving the name as, again, the writer as in the previous. Similarly, let's create a permission, and permission create. Again, the permission name is edit post. This is not related to this role. So let's go here on Chrome, refresh the page, no error. Go to SQL Pro. Now you can see on the roles table we have writer, on the permissions table we have edit post, but we don't have any relation, and we are not going to do that for now. We will do later, but I want to have the something in these two models. So model has permission. So which model we are going to use? Obviously the user model. So how we can use that? So for that you can go to the documentation. If you scroll down, or even if you scroll at the top, you can see we have the user. User give permission, user assign role. So simple thing. Let's go and see how we can do all these things. So here we have, because I have already created the roles and permission, so I'm going to comment these two. And because I am logged in, I can say auth user, which is the default logged in user. So I want to give permission to, like here, edit post. You have seen as I say, as I type. So user give permission to edit post. If I go on the Chrome, refresh the page, no error. SQL Pro, this time on the model has permission table has one entry, and you can see it is now connected with this arrow which says it is connected to permissions, which is edit post. So this is very nice. But we can also attach a role. Okay, so we have seen to attach a role to a user, we need to say assign role. So I will comment this out because again I have done that. So auth user assign role, like this, and the role is writer. Simple enough. Okay. So let's once more go to Chrome, refresh the page. So okay, so we have to give the assigned, okay, and refresh, no error. Now comes here and refresh this has model roles, or actually model has roles table, refresh it. Yeah, again we have, and this is the role which is writer. So now these two tables are filled. This means now user has some role, user has some permission. But how we can check the user has something or not? Okay, so if you scroll down on the documentation, you can see we have something here. Yeah, we have the permissions, so user permission. So let's check this out. So now I will say auth user, and let's move it like this, and permissions, let's see how it's going to look. And go here on the Chrome, let's refresh, and yeah, I have one permission, edit post. This is obviously because we have one permission, but you know, this role doesn't have any permission because role permission don't have anything. So why not add another permission to role. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a permission, and this permission is like write post, because writer can write post. Then I will say permission is equal to this permission, and then I will say the role, which is like role is equal to role and find by ID. So find by ID, and in the last episode we know how it's going to work. So this role, I'm going to assign a permission. So give permission to, and it's like permission, and that has to be inside this permission. Okay, so now if I go here on the Chrome, refresh this page, no error. On the SQL Pro, role has permission having one entry. Now what that means is that this role of writer is connected to permission. So any user has this role automatically get the permission to write the post. So you can see now we have two kind of permission. One permission is write post, which is via role. One permission is edit post, which is not connected to any role. This means because the user has the role of writer, he automatically get the permission to write post. Are you getting it? Because user has the role of writer, and writer is connected to the write post permission, automatically get the write post permission. But we have also said that the user, our user, has the permission to edit post. So what if I try to get the permissions for the user? So let's comment these out, and I'm going to get the permissions. So last time we only get one, but now, oh, still we are getting one. What happened? We have two permissions. One is write post via role, and edit post, which is direct. So here on the documentation, you can get things like get direct permission. So let's see what will be the result of this get direct permission. Okay, so if I refresh, edit post is a direct permission. This permission is not related to any role or not assigned via role. Maybe this can be attached to a role and that role is not assigned to the user, but this is direct. But permissions via role, how is this going to work? This is very, very important. Now if I run this, yeah, you can see now we are getting write post instead of edit post. This is because we have said that, okay, get me the permissions via role. But if I say all permissions like this, what it will give? It will give both of the permissions. So this is very important to have concept of permission directly or permission via role. So in that way, you can have the permission, and you can use these permission to have some kind of access level on your project. So you can also get some users. So if you don't know who is having the role of writer, so you can simply say return user, and I will say get me the user but having the role of writer, and like this. So get me the one like this. So if I say refresh, yeah, this is the one which is having all these role of writer. Similarly, it's very easy to get permission also, and we know write, write post. This is the permission. So again, we are getting that same result because we know that we have only single user and this is connected to permission and role both. So let's just see one more thing. And as usual, you can assign multiple permissions like this. And I have told you this in the last episode also, but it's not so important here. The important part is revoke permission and remove role also. So you can remove the role or you can revoke the permission. So if you want to remove the permission, you need to say revoke permission. So let's say I will going to get permission and then revoke permission. Okay, and the permission name is write post, and let's say edit post because it's a direct post and we are revoking it. So if we want to revoke the permission via role, we need to remove the role itself. So refresh and it says permission. Okay, so it's actually revoke permission 2. Sorry about that. So refresh and yeah, it's there. This means if I go to SQL Pro and refresh this model, yeah, you can see model has permission, doesn't have any value. So in that way, you can also remove the role. So you need to say remove role and role of writer. Let's see it's going to work or not. Okay, so remove role is not there, so maybe we can find another one. Assign role, remove role, it's correct. What's the problem? Remove role re. Okay, so remove role and yeah, no error. This means model has roles is also no data. So I have explained you how you can assign role, how you can remove role, and most important, the difference between the direct permission and permission via role. So in the next episode, we will going to see how we can use the permission to have some kind of access levels on your project. So if you have not subscribed to this channel, go and subscribe to BitFumes and don't forget to hit the bell icon to get instant notification. Like BitFumes on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.